Hello and welcome to this video on creating contracts and plan visits. This video will show you how to create a contract and create reoccurring plan visits. So let's begin. First, find the company you wish to create a contract for, click on Activity, then go to Contracts, then click on New Contract, and in this case we're going to go with Using Wizard, so it shows you all the stages to create a contract. First thing you might do is you might just put a customer reference in the customer reference box. For example, a purchase order number or a reference that the customer has given you. Excellent. Next thing that you might do is put a start date in, and in this case I'm going to put the 1st of May, and you'll see that it defaults to a whole year. You can also click on no end date, so if the contract is rolling, it will carry on rolling because you have no end date. The next thing that you might put in is the contract value. So I'm going to put £5,000 in, and you can also put in a service level agreement. If you put a service level agreement in here, that will go to any job that is created from the contract. You can also put in a type as well of contract. In this case, I'm going for service contract. And then next, I'm also going to go for the level of contract. Bronze, gold or silver, I'm going to select bronze. You can change these in settings, settings and types, and they'll be under contract type and contract level. Okay, once we're happy with that, we can click on next. So the next thing is add the company sites that are valid for this contract. So in this particular contract, I'm going to put two sites that I have under this company for this contract. To do that, we just click on add and we can select those sites. Once you're happy with that, just click on OK. We're going to go next again, and then we're going to see the rates as well. So this means that any job that is created from this contract would apply these rates. You have the option to change these rates if you want to by simply selecting a rate, either changing a custom rate or changing some of your predefined rates that you have here. Once you're happy with that, just click on next. And then you can add a preferred engineer to the contract. So if you want, this would mean that any job that's created from this contract will have these engineers on that particular job for this contract. However, we don't really want to do that. We might want to do that on a per visit schedule basis, or we might just want to assign the engineer as and when. So in this case, I'm going to click on next. And now you can add equipment to the contract if you wish by just clicking on add and selecting the equipment that is on these sites that you've selected for the contract. Once I'm happy with that, I'm just going to click on OK. So we're going to click on next again, and we can add notes and descriptions for job sheets created from the contract. So again, any job sheet that's created from this contract can apply some of these notes or description. However, I'm not going to do that because I want it to be based on a visit schedule. Therefore, I'm going to be using job templates. So again, in this case, I am going to click on next. Now you can also add any products or prices for job sheets created from the contract. So this means that any products that you put in here would apply to any job sheet that is created. Again, I prefer to put this on a job template, so it's visit schedule related, rather than contract related. So again, I am just going to click on next. So now we can start thinking about creating a new visit template. And we're going to create two here, one for each site. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on a new visit template, and we're going to say something like 6 monthly service. Excellent. We've got our description here, 6 monthly service. And now we're going to say, what site does that apply to? So in this case, we're going to go for the Bulldog. And we're going to say that these visits tend to last all day. However, you can untick that and you could say it starts at 9 o'clock, for example, and it might finish at, say, 12 o'clock. You can also say the duration is just one day, but you could increase that to 2, 3 days or how many days you wish. The next bit is the job template. So this is what we're sort of describing earlier. So basically, I want a particular job template to apply to every job that is created from this visit schedule. So to do that, I just click on browse, and I'll have a list of different kind of job templates. And in this case, I'm just going to use the one called service because it's got everything that I need. It's also got some description in, so you can see here, please do service on wind turbine. I might have some action list that I want to auto apply as well, and I might also have a product that I want to apply as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply that. So that means that any jobs that get created from this visit schedule will apply that job template. The next thing I'm going to do is click on the second tab, which is equipment, and I'm going to add one of the assets, which is going to be in the use visit site equipment bit, and it's going to be this particular boiler. So it's going to create a job sheet with that asset on it. What you can also do is you can say, okay, for this particular visit template, I want this engineer to be assigned to these templates, and that will go to every job sheet that this visit template creates. So I'm going to click on add, and I could add an engineer. In this case, I'm not going to. I'm going to cancel that because I just want to assign an engineer as and when. Okay, next bit is the important bit, and it's setting up the recurrence. So how often do you want to go to this site and do a service on this boiler? So what we're going to do is we're going to click on setup recurrence, and we're going to click on monthly, and I'm going to say the first weekday of every 6 months. I'm going to say I want the range of recurrence to start on the 1st of May 2023, and I want it to be no end date, so it carries on rolling and it's up to me to sort of end this contract. However, I could say end by a particular date if I wish, or you can end after a number of occurrences as well. But in this case, no end date. Once I'm happy with that, I'm just going to click on OK, and it's going to ask me, would you like to create the next scheduled visit for this template? And I'm going to say yes. So what that's done is it's created the visit and a job sheet associated with that visit as well. So once I'm happy with that, I can click on OK, and we know that's done. So we're going to create another new visit template by clicking on new visit template. And this time I might put in yearly service. We can then select another site. So we'll go for the main site. We'll click on the equipment. We'll click on add, and we'll use this boiler here and press OK. And then we could go to engineer and add an engineer, but in this case, I'm not going to. And we're going to go to job template down here, click on browse, and I'm going to select service again. And we're just going to click apply to apply that job template. Now I'm going to go on setup recurrence, but this time I'm going to go yearly, and I'm going to say first day of May, no end date. So we're going to click OK, and then click yes. And now that has created another visit and another job. Okay. So once you're happy with doing all your scheduled visit templates, you can then click on next, and you might look at doing a reoccurring invoice if you want. However, in this case, I am only going to raise an invoice after each completed visit. So I don't really need to create a reoccurring invoice, but if you want to, you can do, and you can create them if you wish. Now we're going to click on next, and we're going to have a look at the contract summary that's going to give us some details about that contract. We can use the print to print that out if you want to, just to see what it looks like, and you could potentially send it to your customer. However, I'm quite happy with that. I'm going to click on finish, and that's it. We have now created our contract. So what we can see in our contract is we can see the visits here. So we can see the yearly service and the 6 monthly service that are both going on the 1st of May at two different sites. What you'll see is if you click on the job sheets over here, you'll be able to see the job sheets there. And if we double click on it, we can see the job sheet with the pre-filled information that has been created, and we can see the equipment that's associated with that job and associated with the contract. What you'll also be able to see is you'll be able to see reoccurring visit schedules, and you'll be able to see what's happening with your schedule. So for example, in a 6 monthly service, we can see it started on the 1st of May 2023, and the last created visit was the 1st of May 2023. And the next visit is due on the 1st of the 11th, 2023. So it's giving you an indication of when the next visit is due. But what's really important is up here. So we can see here we're automatically creating visits 30 days ahead, which in turn will automatically create a job sheet for each visit. So I know that 30 days before the 1st of the 11th, 2023, a job is going to be created for this visit. You can change this, so you can obviously edit it. So if you want to, you might want 90 days notice, or some people will change it to 365 days if they want to see all those visits straight away. So if you did this, you can click on here, you can go to visits, and you'll see auto create visits and jobs now for the next 365 days. Okay, so the next thing that we're going to talk about is we're just going to go to reminders. So reminders at the top here, you can select people to have reminders about when a next visit is due or when the contract is ending. So as you can see here, enable end date reminders, 30 days before the contract is ending, you will get reminded. And if you want a visit reminder, you can enable a visit reminder and you'll get that 7 days before that visit at 9 o'clock. However, we need to select some people to get that reminder. To do that, you just go down in users and then you select the user you wish. So in this case, I've got Paul Benson. He'll get notified 7 days before the next visit that there's a visit due. And so you get reminded and prompted just to make sure everything is okay. You might call that customer to make sure it's okay for you to go and do that service. Okay, once you're happy with your contract, you just click on save. And then we'll just click on close. And then that's it. That's how you create a contract from the wizard. Thanks very much for listening.